Hi there, and this is Hoohaa Sports Today, a daily sports update and review show covering all that's happening in your world of football and beyond. Today we will recap on all that happened at the weekend in the Premier League, as it's proving to be a topsy-turvy season. A quick look at the standings and how they got there. United have started distancing themselves from the chasing pack, thanks to neighbours Manchester City giving up a 2-goal lead and settling for a 2-2 draw with Fulham. Despite the loss, Chelsea maintained third, while Newcastle's draw with Aston Villa and Stoke's 4-0 loss to Sunderland also keeps them where they were in the standings last week. Everton moved above their Merseyside neighbours, while QPR's inspired 3-0 victory over Wolves sees them in ninth. And we have to look at the bottom half to find Spurs and Arsenal. Tottenham fans are still on a high after that win over Liverpool. Not just the scoreline, but more so with the team's performance. Lots of credit going to new signing Scotty Parker. Norwich's away win at Bolton and Swansea's 3-0 drubbing of West Brom at home moved the new boys away from the relegation zone, while Arsenal's defeat to Blackburn sees them in unfamiliar territory, their worst start to a Premier League season, and they have conceded a massive 14 goals in just 5 matches. The only other two sides to have conceded more goals over the same number of games are Southampton in the 1998-99 campaign and Derby in the 2007-08 season. In the end, Southampton survived relegation, finishing fourth from bottom, while not so fortunate for Derby. They finished rock bottom and were relegated. Not the kind of stats an Arsenal fan would want to hear. But the weekend's highlights was the United-Chelsea game, and it will be remembered as a fine collection of misses.
Fernando Torres had a chance, but hey, guess what? He didn't score. Well, just about 25 minutes into the game, such a pulsating start to this match between United and Chelsea. An open chance to get the scores level, but Chelsea, well, what do you know, it's their middle name. They missed it again. It's coming up to the 56th minute. Rooney against Pitacek. Oh! Rooney's put it wide. Could have been number 4, but it wasn't. Close, 2 tries, and then it was out from the post. How can he have not scored that one? He is doomed. Brilliant chance. Dribbled at 4 defenders. Defended the goalkeeper. And he scuffed it.
Yes, that Torres miss is already being labelled as miss of the season. I think as he dribbled past David De Gea, Torres was already believing he put the goal drought behind him and was probably preparing for his goal celebration. But the consequence of it will haunt him for a long time. On the Chelsea Facebook page, a lot has been said about that miss. But I like Michael Mognato's comments on how lucky United were with a recap of the Chelsea misses, and doesn't want to even mention about Torres' fumble. Well, allow me to share my personal embarrassment from the weekend, the outcome of my weekend predictions. I only got the Rangers and Everton one right, and how in the world did I pick Chelsea over United? But hey, they could have overhauled United, and who would have thought Arsenal would lose to Blackburn or even Manchester City, giving up a 2-goal lead. And the producer's verdict is, sorry Torres, I guess when it rains, it pours. And alright, that's plenty for today. We'll have more for you tomorrow. Till then, from the team and I, it's bye for now.